Welcome to my biology class, and today we just go with protistas, fourth division, slime molds, and the fifth one, protozoan. The first three we discussed in the previous video. Now I'll just start with slime mold. Slime mold is otherwise called as myxomycota, that is mycee fungi. Previously it was placed under fungi, but according to Whittaker, since it is a single cell organism, it has been placed under protista. So when you talk about slime mold, the foremost thing is no cell wall in it. It is very slimy. The outer thing is very slimy. Even the body is something very special. Actually, they form from the diploid zygote and form a special structure like a whey. The milk whey is there, no? Just like that. It spreads in few meters, even you could say, and that is called plasmodium. This plasmodium is free living, diploid, because it is coming from the diploid zygote, and it is somatic and it is acellular, but it is diploid plasmodium with multinucleate condition. So this plasmodium forms in a suitable condition. It is not unfavorable, it is suitable condition. Every word is important in this. In a suitable condition, they'll form a plasmodium, but during unfavorable condition, they go with this sporangium. Okay, so this leaf like, and they just spread widely and form a small veinlets, like vein kind of a thing runs. And when the conditions are quite unfavorable, what they do is they just form a cyst, a bulb like small cyst, and it will be undergoing rest, and then they'll bust out and each one will become a new plasmodium like. This is one thing. Or when this plasmodium matures to the fullest size, after fully matured, and when they are deprived of the food, what they do is the entire content, the nucleate content and the plasmodium, the inner cell content, everything collected in one part, and from there they'll start sprouting as a small stalk like this, and the stalk end they'll form a sporangium. This is formed, and this sporangium will bust out, and then they release the spores. These spores will be liberated in air current. And the more important thing in the spores are, the spores have got a cell wall. See, this plasmodium doesn't, the slime mold on the whole, there is no cell wall, but the spores have got a cell wall. And also this will be placed, actually this, they are all saprophytes. They just grow on the dead and debris, leaves, fragments on that, and they decay them, and organic content they consume and they live. So this is their lifestyle, but the spores are liberated in air current. These are all very important points, and they are very colorful too. Understood? And see, this plasmodium is different from this plasmodium. This plasmodium is a genus name. This plasmodium is just a structure. So when you get it in your exam, if the plasmodium in italics, that is this. If the plasmodium in normal letter, then this is this plasmodium. Okay? So this is about slime mold. So when you come to the next division, protozoa. Protozoans means, proto means very similar, very single cellular, animalcules, rather you can call them as an animal, it is animalcule. These groups have been classified on the basis of their locomotory organ, you could say. The first one is amoeboid, the second one is flagellated, and the third one is cilia, and the fourth one is sporozoan. So you know the amoeboid, okay, pseudopodians, they've got a pseudopodia. Pseudo means false, podium means locomotory organ. So they have a false footed animals. They don't have a specific this kind of a shape for a locomotor, nothing like. It depends. See, in case if they see the food here, this can extend like this. Accordingly, this size will be coming in like. So in case if they find the food here, this will be extending, this will be coming. So for the streaming movement inside the body, according to the food, they just move. Even their cytoplasm is ectoplasm and endoplasm. They are two types, like how we have seen in Euglena. And they do have a contractile vacuole, very important, because they are freshwater or marine fauns. And this contractile vacuoles will maintain their water content in their body, osmoregulators. And see, in case of a marine form, say especially the Sacanthometra and all, their body is covered by a silica. So to withstand the water current and other things. So this is about amoeba, or you can have even entamoeba, Entamoeba histolytica, which causes dysentery. And entamoeba also, they are not completely aquatic. They are in the bottom of the pond kind, in the subterrestrial like that. And they do have a contractile vacuole, but one or two will be there. They have only one pseudopodium, but amoeba has got more number of pseudopodia. So when you talk about a flagellata, see here, this is the long lengthy flagella, is a locomotory organ. Their internal structure and all more or less similar, but they don't have a contractile vacuole. That is one. See, out of 1, 2, 3, 4 groups, two groups, this is flagellata and sporozoans, don't have contractile vacuole. These two category has got a contractile vacuole. It's all exam question. Okay, so here they have a flagella and trypanosoma and leishmania. This you would have heard about it, African sleeping sickness caused by trypanosoma, and kala-azar, this is caused by leishmania. Both have got a flagella. Otherwise the internal structure and all similar, except this contractile vacuole. And when you talk about ciliated protozoans, see, the entire body is covered by cilia, and this is looking like a slipper. So the paramecium is called as a slipper animalcule, and they have a plasma membrane. Just like Euglena, they do have a pellicle, a slime sheath is covering the plasma membrane, with the cilia is present throughout. With the help of that, they are just moving. This is one thing, the similarity, like pellicle is a similar feature like an Euglena. And another thing, they've got a small groove here. This is the oral groove through which only the food particle will enter into the body of an animal. And here it is just going like a tube like a thing. This is called cytopharynx, or a gullet you could say, like a pharynx like structure, and the food particle will go. This is again similar similarity with the Euglena. And here one special feature is they've got two nucleus in it. One is bigger size, macronuclei, and then small one is micronuclei. They have a contractile vacuole to adjust the water balance in their body. That is the speciality of a paramecium with cilia. So cilia is the locomotory organ. When you come down to sporozoans, they are very special. There is no locomotory organ at all, but they produce spores. Spores in the sense, there is a syngamy. Syngamy means the male and female. Syn means joint. The male and the female will come and meet, and they form a diploid, and then it will undergo a division to form a spores. The spores are something very special. You know, they have a variety of stages. Like they have a sporozoites, merozoites, cryptomerozoite stage, schizont stage, and the stages, every stage, the spore structure changes, round or signet ring, a single studded ring like, or again somewhat lengthy, like they shape changes, but there is no any specific locomotory organ in this. And so they are just called sporozoans. And this is Plasmodium, the one which causing the malarial parasite. So please note it down that if it is under italics, it is Plasmodium vivax, malarial parasite. If it is in a normal letter, it is this Plasmodium. Don't get confused with. So This is about protozoans. So protozoans have been classified on the basis of their locomotory organ. Here there is absolutely no locomotory organ. So this is about the entire protista. Three divisions we discussed in previous videos, the two in this video. Please go through both, and then if you have any doubt or any comment, you please pass it in the comment section. And thank you very much, and please subscribe this too.